Good morning and welcome to the WSN, the Woodville School News. I'm your anchor, Burgundy. Today's joke. What did the sock say to the foot?
I don't know, what?
Shoe. Now please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning. It is Thursday, February 27th, and now a very special guest.
Good morning, Marvelous Mustangs. Look who I have here with me this morning. We have a special guest today. We have Jasmine Williams from Cobb Realty. She is going to be the principal for a day. That's right. She, Miss Williams, is your principal today. Isn't that right, Miss Williams?
That's right. Good morning.
Now, when you see her around campus, please make sure you say hi, introduce yourself, and if you have any issues you'd like to talk to her about, go for it. I will see you around campus, and Miss Williams, anything you'd like to share?
I look forward to meeting you all today.
All right. We'll see you guys around campus. Have a good day.
Good morning. I'm Mr. Irv, and I have our moment in Black history. Today, we're going to talk about the Underground Railroad. The Underground Railroad was the network used by enslaved Black Americans to obtain their freedom in the 30 years before the Civil War, from 1860 to 1865. The railroad used many routes from states in the South, which supported slavery, to the free states in the North and Canada. Sometimes routes of the Underground Railroad were organized by abolitionists who opposed slavery, but more often the network was a series of small individual actions to help fugitives reach freedom. Using the terminology of the railroad, those who went south to find enslaved people seeking freedom were called pilots. Those who guided the enslaved people to safety and freedom were called the conductors. The enslaved people were referred to as the passengers. People's homes or businesses where fugitive passengers and conductors could safely hide were referred to as stations. While the number is often debated, some believe that as many as 100,000 slaves escaped on the Underground Railroad. However, this is only a tiny percentage of the slaves living in the South during this period. That's all we have for this morning, and now back to our anchor.
Thank you, Mr. Earp, and now the weather. Today will be mainly sunny, high near 55. This evening, look for clear skies, low 32. Sunset will be at 6:34. Tomorrow, look for it to be sunny, high 62. Now, today's birthdays. Today, we have three Woodville birthdays. So let's all wish a happy birthday to Cameron Ferguson in second grade, Alice Powell in first grade, and James Sloan in eighth grade. Happy birthday to all of you. Today's lunch, choose one, corn dog nuggets, chef salad, or veg chef salad and crackers, choose up to do. Baked beans, sweet and spicy potatoes, choose one. Assorted fruit, assorted 100% fruit juice. Thought of the day, when you have a bad day, treat the world better than it treated you. Okay, that's all we have for today. Thank you for tuning into the Woodville School News. We'll see you on campus.